that's the best I can give to them. Yes. The great smile. Hallelujah.
President Museveni and the First Lady Janet Museveni first exchanged their marriage commitment vows at Chamate Church of Uganda in Entungamo District at a function presided over by the Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, Dr. Stephen Kazimba Mugalu.
Yoweri Kaguta Habwa Museveni, take you, Janet Kataha Museveni again, to continue to be my beloved wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better and for worse, for richer and for poorer, in health and in sickness, to love and to cherish till death do us part, according to God's holy law, and this is my solemn vow.
Janet Kataha Museveni, take you, Yoweri Kaguta Habwa Museveni, again to continue to be my beloved husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better and for worse, for richer and for poorer, in health and in sickness, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy law, and this is my solemn vow.
President Museveni used the occasion to remind people to always differentiate between what he said was life and facilitation to life. The president noted that, whereas other worldly things such as wealth, education and professionalism are important, the real meaning of life is in family and the marriage institution because it guarantees the continuity of humanity.
You talk of education, I am educated. You talk of wealth, I am rich. You talk of professional development, but all those are facilitations for life. Life itself is family. Family, which means wife, means children, means grandchildren. That's life.
The president further thanked God for the gift of life, noting that without life, they wouldn't have been able to get married, have children and grandchildren.
By thanking God first for life, and life meant saving just mom and myself who were born here, we are indigenous of this area, saving us from disease.
President Museveni further used the occasion to thank the people of Greater Ankole, Uganda and the African continent at large for the support they rendered to their family and the bigger Ugandan family, especially during the difficult times of bad governance, wars and life in exile. He called upon Ugandans to stop working for only food and join the money economy to boost their income and get rid of poverty in their home states.
68% we are producing for home consumption. And that's where the poverty is. So we said, no, you must, and they all have land. It's not like in Europe, you find people don't have land. But here families all have land, but they don't use it. They only use it for home consumption.
In her speech, Mrs. Museveni said that their 50-year celebration was a commemoration of God's faithfulness to them and their family.
Kureba ngo ruhanga turabizo mu buna kubugumire emirundi minge kintu cyona kikandi kibasa kutubaho kuko mukono gwa ruhanga ugwembabazi ukaturinda gwa turabyumbuna kobwo batukozese emirimo yitutakubasize gukora nk'abantu.
The First Lady thanked Ugandans for sparing time to celebrate with them on their special day in their life, in an area where both were born, raised and studied. In his sermon, His Grace Dr. Stephen Kazimba Mugalu greatly commended President Museveni for being a good example of a family man and for standing firm to protect the family institution that he said was under attack globally. He thanked President Museveni and the First Lady Janet Museveni for not forgetting to thank God whenever they reach any milestone in their life.
What a joy. To God be the glory. As a church, as a body of believers, we are so proud of you. that you are doing this. This is not for your family. It is for the entire nation of Uganda.
President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, later at the reception, applauded the First Lady Janet Kataha Museveni for exhibiting resilience and courage in raising their children despite his permanent absenteeism during the liberation struggle period.
That's where Mama Janet now comes in. And not only being a mother, but a mother of children with a permanently absentee husband. You heard what the children were saying, that she was tough with them and was able to bring them up for a number of years without my presence. And I really salute her for that.
The First Lady also expressed her gratitude towards her husband for agreeing to celebrate this important day in Ntungamo district and not either in Rakitura or Kampala.
To have your spouse and give him peace, just let him be. What he wants to do, let him do, because it's nothing. And now I know that really, and he knows, I don't follow him picking up things and saying.
Other family members also congratulated the president and the first lady for reaching this day.
This day and the befitting celebration of these 50 years is really to thank God, who has been so faithful to these two people, our parents.
They got married in the UK because their very lives were under threat, and it wasn't safe for them to be in Uganda, much less get married here. But today, on their golden jubilee celebration, they are in Ntungamo, their ancestral home, and the origin of both their families, surrounded by children, grandchildren, relatives, friends, hundreds of spiritual children, and thousands of well-wishers.
On the other hand, the Yoruba Kingdom of Nigeria also thanked God for the gift of life he has given to the couple that has enabled them to celebrate the milestone.
We thank God Almighty for your life. A lot has been said about this couple. You are an epitome of a true African because we are connected to nature.
The event was attended by a number of dignitaries, several government officials, religious personalities, international guests, among others. Among the high-profile guests were the Vice President, Jessica Alupo, the Prime Minister, Robina Nabanja, the former Vice President, Edward Sekandi, among others.